tackling demonetization, causes, effects, and way ahead. Prabuddha Bharat takes pleasure in presenting this program for the citizens of Belgaum on this burning issue which has gripped our nation for the past 3 weeks or so. Na hi jnanena sadrusham pavitram hi vidyate. There is nothing more sacred than knowledge. This is the motto of Prabuddha Bharat or Awakened India. It is with this in mind that the organizers have planned a lecture on demonetization today. May I request the convener, Sri Chaitanya Kulkarni, to escort our chief guest, Sri Rajendra Belgaonkar, and our esteemed speaker, Sri M.R. Venkatesh, to the dais. A garland is made, so by a mortal in this life, there is much good work to be done, said the Buddha. May I request the dignity to offer floral tributes to the statue of Swami Vivekananda. We will offer a Shraddhanjali to our martyrs. It has been 8 years since 26/11, and countless soldiers have died defending our motherland before and after the war. A nation that forgets its martyrs will itself be forgotten. As a tribute to our martyrs, let us stand in silence for 1 minute. Let noble thoughts come to us from every side, says Arucha from the roadway. Kumari Swati Deshpande will now invoke the gallery with a vayaktik gita.
Chaitre
Nirman ke power mein hum charitra nirman na bhule. Thank you Swati for that melodious invocation. Arise, awake and stop not till the goal is achieved. Uttishthat jagrata pratyam is a verse from the Kanthopanishad used by Swami Vivekananda to awaken our country from its hypnotized state of mind. Although he used it in the 19th century, it remains relevant today. It is with the intention of creating awareness about nation building that Prabuddha Bharat is actively involved in a variety of programs and events of social relevance since 2013. I invite the treasurer of Prabuddha Bharat, Sri Anand Rudeva, to welcome the gathering.
It is on the dais of the dais, ladies and gentlemen. Before a formal welcome, let me brief about Prabuddha Bharat Belagavi. Prabuddha Bharat is a forum inspired by the life of warrior monk Sri Swami Vivekananda with one vision to see that Mother Bharati is awakened once more. It is a platform of positive, patriotic and professional individuals founded during 150th birth anniversary celebration of Swami Vivekananda. Deriving immense inspiration from the philosophy of Swamiji based on the ideas, we draw upon the wealth of our heritage which says, Nahi Jnanena Sadrusham Pavitramiha Vidyate. That is nothing but there is nothing like knowledge which purifies. We have got a vision which to inspire, infuse and install Bharatiyata as a path of life. And Prabuddha Bharata Belagavi has got a mission also where to promote research and understanding in Bharatiya samskaras and Sanskriti and integrate social, economical, educational, political and spiritual perspective of thought and practice by providing a platform for the emergence and exchange of inspired and nationalistic intellectuals. Prabuddha Bharata Belagavi has been organizing lectures series on a regular basis by inviting internationally acclaimed speakers to speak on various topics of national relevance with global perspectives. These are Sri Ram Madhav, Sri Champat Rai, Sri Arun Kumarji, Srimati Indumati Kattare, Dr. Subbanna Bhatt, Sri Ravi Kumar Iyer, Srimati Shantakka, Sri Sarod Hole, Sri Vinayak Kovindkar, and Sri Prasad Pandi. Very recently in September, we organized the STEP, the State of National Enclave, a 2 days intellectual conference where about 400 invitees across the various professions along with about 300 university students participated in highly stimulating deliberations on the social, technological, economic and political transformation of Bharat. This was an initiative of Prabuddha Bharata Belagavi in bringing together some of the finest minds of the nation striving with a single point agenda to realize a unified and unique nationhood to the Bharat. It was an enhancement of our commitment in building a healthy society through deliberation based on objectives, intellectual and nationality perspective. The sessions were designed for a select gathering and the stalwarts like Sri Gurumurthy, Tarun Vijay, Sri V. Nagraj and Dr. Satish Reddy, who is a scientific advisor to the Raksha Mantri, were the keynote speakers. In this effort, we thought that about 3 weeks back, we are in a nation changing mode where our Honorable Prime Minister has announced the demonetization of the 500,000 notes. So we thought we can have to, in the same line what we are doing here, to conduct another such program by inviting eminent speakers on this subject. So we pinned on finally to invite Sri Venkatesh ji, who is, if at all we have to introduce him, it is a big list where we cannot, personality cannot be taught or teach or told in a words. So definitely the words which he is going to speak in next one and a half hour will be his main introductions. So I welcome Sri Venkatesh ji for this function. I welcome Sri Raj, who is known as Raj only, the Balram for comes later, to this function. So may I request Sri Raj to hand over a small moment to Sri Venkatesh ji on this moment. Once again, I welcome you all for this function. Thank you.
Thank you, Anand ji. Our Chief Guest, Sri Rajendra Bhedavkar, has vast experience in the field of finance and economics. Prabuddha Bharat would also like to honor him with a memento. May I request Sri M.R. Venkatesh to honor our Chief Guest. We are all in the exchange mode now. A few days ago, I have heard an excellent presentation by Sri Raj Bhedavkar on the issue of demonetization at another forum. His well-researched and informative speeches are always a treat to our ears. Although soft-spoken, his words have the right impact when and where needed. To set the proceedings of this evening rolling, I request Sri Bhedavkar to give his opening remarks.
My friends from Prabuddha Bharat, honorable citizens of civic society of Belgaum, it is an undeserving honor for me to share this stage with a man of this erudition and expertise. I will do my best to limit my remarks and save time and have Mr. Venkatesh spend more time, so I will not bore you with my ignorance. All of us were stunned on November 8th when Prime Minister Modi ji in the evening announced his actions. It has been audacious, it has been a brilliant move to curb, but it has to be, to the best of my opinion, seen in the light of a series of events and not as an isolated event. There was the Aadhaar card, there was the account, there was IDS, there was passage of the GST bill, passage of the real estate bill, then this tsunami that hit us on November 8th. Yes, there have been some issues here and there in terms of the execution, but what gives hope to people like me is the fact that people at the top, and especially our Prime Minister, seem to be operating after a long gap in our country of decades, with a plan to really help the citizenry of our country. And in that light, the little pain that all of us may or may not have suffered has to be viewed as a small price to pay for a larger directional change in the way our country is going. So, demonetization, yes, some issues here and there in execution, but what gives people like me hope is the fact that I'm sure there are many other steps. A person cannot take six steps in continuation and then say this is my last step. I am sure there are many other coordinated, well thought out steps that have been thought of by this government to complement the decisions taken so far, so that the overall direction of our country is hopefully and finally changed towards truly helping the Aam Aadmi or the citizen of this country for once after so many years. So without wasting too much of your time, I sincerely look forward to handing over at the advice of our people here, the next speaker to you. And I thank you so much for hearing me patiently.
Rajasya Mulam Indriyajam. With this Chanakya Sutra, may I invite our keynote speaker, Sri M.R. Venkatesh.
My namaskars to you. I note from the program sheet, the program ends by around 8 o'clock. 8 o'clock, all of us nowadays have a habit of switching on the TV to see Bhaiyo or Behno. November 8th, somebody asked me, kya ho gaya? What has changed? What will happen? What will not happen? I So that is a trailer of a small movie, main picture baki hai. Understand what is the context of how and why this has happened. Why the criticisms are happening. Quality of the criticisms that comes in. Who is criticizing? Where they are criticizing? The usual suspects with the usual tone are criticizing. All points out anecdotally to a very large malice in this country. To some of us who have been actively involved in this war on black money, I would think that this is a very historic step. I am not saying that the war has ended. I am not even using the word battle has started, nothing like that. I am using the word very advisedly. This is the first step. Because you have to understand the malice. To understand it, I will try to give you a broad picture about the color of money. Because every time I open the pages of newspaper, they say war against black money. This black money is a kindergarten stuff. Some of you may be chartered accountants here, and I myself a chartered accountant. I keep reminding that myself every day. So that is the only reason I'm saying that I'm a chartered accountant. That black money is a product of violating income tax law. As simple as that. And in this country, those of us who earn above the threshold limit will be having some black money, because income tax law in this country is very vague. It is far more vague than the Upanishads. So as a student of income tax law, I can tell you it is very difficult to understand income tax law. Income tax law is like an elephant, and we chartered accountant lawyers are like people who are visually impaired. We touch it and say this is like a tree, this is like a fan, this is like that. All of us have got some understanding, not the total understanding of the law. So all of us could be having some black money. So we are innocent carriers of black money at best. But black money is, again, it has got a very, very bad connotation. It starts from 60s and 70s, or even perhaps the 40s and the 50s, the movies, any movie in Hindi, Bengali, Tamil, Kannada. It will be like this: if you are rich, you are a villain. If you are poor, you are a hero. And the rich could not have become richer because the laws were so draconianly drafted that unless you beat the law, you can never be rich. So the whole idea of portraying somebody, when this country celebrated prosperity, we are the only civilization where, say, Lakshmi Mata is there, where we celebrate the greatness of knowledge simultaneously with greatness of prosperity. And in this civilization, suddenly it was declared that if you are rich, kale dande kar rahe ho, gold smuggling kar rahe ho, heroin bech rahe ho, charash bech rahe ho. So this went along with what is called as the socialistic or Nehruvian idea of what should be an ideal India. We celebrated poverty. Satyajit Ray became a great movie maker only by depicting India as a land of poor and people were struggling to have their two square meals. But that came about because the rates of taxes, seniors are here, they will bear me out. I am told that the rates of taxes were as high as 96%, 98% beyond 2 lakh rupees. And you have to pay 6% wealth tax. So at the end of the day, if you earn more than 2 lakhs, actually your income started depleting. Even the British did not have this type of system on us. And that created this black money. I am not batting for the black money people. I am only saying this created a Tom and Jerry game between the government and the people, where howsoever the government may be intelligent, it was only Tom. The people were Jerry. They were outsmart because the chartered accountants and the lawyers found out that income tax law was the gold mine. This is not my words. These are the words of the late Palkiwala, who told this in 1990s when I was a student. And income tax now act is not a gold mine. Today it is a diamond mine. That is the level of complexity, but that is not the issue I am going to talk about. But this black money then becomes red money. Red money is not only you pay tax and get away. Now take the 2G scamsters. They earned in crores. They earned hundreds of crores, thousands of crores. So this red money is not an ordinary money. This is crime money. The moment I talk about my state people, Raja, Kanimuri and all, supervening, you know, interjections. And these are people who are not people who are to be, who have violated the income tax law. You can't go and tell somebody who has got 1,000 crores of bribe money, pay 30% income tax and this money is pure, take it. The source of this money itself is bad. The entire money is bad. The Gangotri of this money is bad. And that money belongs to the government whether you pay taxes or not. So this is red money. It has assumed alarming proportions. And somebody asked me in one of the local news channel, sir, whether this 1,000 rupee note, 500 rupee note banning will remove corruption. I said, have you ever taken or given 25 lakh rupee bribe? Then you will know what is the importance of 1,000 rupees and 500 rupees. Only those who have given or taken or seen the transaction happening will understand the importance of taking high density notes. So this red money had become so dangerous that it had spread to all arms of our society, whether it is judiciary, whether it is bureaucracy, whether it is executive, politics, it had gone everywhere. So if you have cash, you are king. And more cash you have, you are an emperor. So this type of moral degradation happened simultaneously, that started hurting us at every field. Children who were to play under 16, who are aged 15 or 16, said, if we can pay some money, I can go into under 14. This is the level to which we have degraded our society. That if you can bribe, you can do anything. That is why Mr. Narendra Modi in one of the meetings said, and he put it in a very brilliant manner, it is not that copying did not happen during Gandhi's time. Students used to copy also. People used to carry some small bits of paper, take it like this, see it slyly, and copy something. It would have happened in my father's time, in my grandfather's time, no doubt about it. But today, students said, you know what I did? I copied today. So brazen. Copy nahi kiya. Sharam nahi chahiye. This brazenness has happened, that you are known by the brazenness with which you do a dirty act. So the shamelessness has become a virtue because of this 1,000 rupee and 500 rupee notes, you know, proliferation. So this tackles the red money. Now come to the green money. Green money is printed in our neighboring country. The only thing that they were exporting to our country, but it was good quality. And you know, some of the foolishness that we did in the last 10-15 years was that we used to source the paper from the same source Pakistan was sourcing. Our printing press machinery, I am told, were not destroyed properly. They found some or the other to the places. These are all rumors. I do not know whether it's verified, unverified, but the fact remains, Pakistan started printing counterfeit notes far better than it was actually printed in Nashik. And that found a way into our country. It's the truth of the matter. The fourth money that we need to tackle is the grey money. The grey money is the hawala money, which is our own money, goes abroad and comes back into India after being laundered in Dubai, in Mauritius, in Singapore, in various other places, Switzerland, Panama, Cayman Islands, Cyprus, Isle of Man, Gibraltar, you name it, there are 72 other places where it's called tax havens. You take your money out, just like you will take your shirt out, wash it in a washing machine, comes back after being laundered. You can do the money laundering and it comes back. And once it comes back, it is called foreign direct investment. No questions asked. It is given right of highway. So just like an ambulance can rush in a highway, you FDA means that's all. No questions asked. these are the four types of money that started plaguing our market, our morality, our systems, our constitution. It was subverting and eating into the vitals of every single institution known to this country. So what is this demonetization all about? We all know 1,000 rupee note and 500 rupee note. No longer a legal tender. We have been given time till 30th December to go and exchange it. Now that exchange window is also over, we have to go and actually deposit into our accounts so that people will know whether we have actually had this account and we can actually show the proof of it. And if it is not, you are not able to show the source, government is contemplating some taxes. What is untold? There is a provision in the Income Tax Act, I'm sure chartered accountants will bear me out. There is an eternal VDIS scheme in the Income Tax Act called Section 68, 69A, 69B, 69C, 69D, where you expend something or you invest something which source is not proved, in that year it will be taken as tax. So it will be simple 30%. So we chartered accountants are still debating whether it will attract penalty or no, whether you should disclose or shouldn't disclose, but that is a smaller order of smalls. I am not going to go into it. But the larger question is, supposing you have 25 crores and you deposit into your account, can you get away by saying that I have got this income this year by 25 crores and pay 30% tax? 7.5 crores. You may still get out of the Income Tax Act. But the Money Laundering Act, ED may issue a notice to you of the source. Because black money is simple income tax violation or tax violation. But once you violate the law and earn your income, it becomes red money, and automatically Enforcement Directorate will start issuing notice. So people who have huge amount of money, who cannot exchange it, even 4,000 rupees, that is why you should see the brilliance of the scheme. The brilliance of the scheme is that it allowed only 4,000 rupees of withdrawal per day, or 25,000, 24,000 rupees in a week. And they have stopped it now. Whatever money you have to necessarily go and put it either in your bank account or Tirupati Hundi. Only two choice. And this scheme, people have accused this scheme that you have not given time, you have not prepared, you have not told us. I said, we will give 21-day notice to Pakistan to do a surgical strike. This is a surgical strike, so you cannot have a notice. So at 8 p.m. when the Prime Minister announced, I thought it should have even been a bit later at 9 p.m. You know, you shouldn't even have given that half an hour, 45 minute time. Now this timing has been done with such great that people are now stuck with hordes of cash. And in this country, you would understand that people have been queuing in this line in banks with utmost discomfort for the last 20 days now. People, according to media, have died standing in the line. The opposition parties, those who are opposed to the scheme, want riots, want breakdown of law and order. And the Indian, average Indian, responds by telling, damn it, I will stand in the queue very, very silently, very, very obediently, I will exchange my money. And that is how he responds to the Prime Minister. This is the faith a leader can have on the common man. If you give the right type of trigger, this society will automatically respond. And in this response, it is not that this caste has responded, that community has responded. It is from Kashmir to Kanyakumari, from Kohima to Kandla, everybody has responded uniformly. Everybody has uniformly stood in the queue. I have not seen something like this in any other country. In any other country, country would have been divided. You cannot think of this type of experiment anywhere in the world. 86% of your currency notes are being declared invalid overnight. Now our economists, textbook economists in New Delhi, do not know what to say because no other country has done it. So there is no role model. So they are saying this is organized loot and plunder. Why? Because your Oxford did not teach you. Why your you know, foreign universities have not discussed this. 86% case study, 86% of currency note, if it is delegitimized, demonetized, what will happen? 20 marks, discuss. Our great professor does not know. So he stands up and he is so angry that this has happened. Now you look at it, this can happen only who has got outmost disaffection to the seat that occupies. Only when you don't have love for the seat, when you don't have lust for the seat that you occupy, you can do this. If you are so spineless that you cannot even show a spine during an X-ray machine also, you cannot do it. I am not naming anybody. And people are responding. And they are responding in the way they know that whenever there is a Sagar Manthan, first there will be wish. Indians may not know how to articulate this position, but they know whenever you do some churning, the first thing that will come is only wish. That won't be Amrit. Amrit comes at the fag end, like the police in every Hindi movie. It will come in the fag end. First thing that comes is only your wish. And you will have to eat, you have to drink. And only when you drink, you will have the ability and stomach it, you will get Amrit. Sir, first scene mein Amrit aa jayega, toh movie khatam. And the average Indian knows this, that he has to undergo this pain. Average Indian also knows that the people who are shouting are the people who are only two kinds. The politicians and media sponsored by these politicians. There is no intellectual, honest debate in this country on this demonetization. I have not seen one politician standing up, only one day or 1.5 days there has been a debate. I did watch it. But frankly, I did not see one single sentence to say, mitigate the problems of the common man in terms of dealing with this issue. We are against black money, but that but goes on for 1.5 hours. In Tamil Nadu, there is a peculiar thing. In Tamil Nadu, media is held by only two types of people. One is the political media. One is held by people who cater to the education. Education and media are interlinked in my state. And you know, whether you do not know the price of tomato or potato, you will know how much does an MD seat cost. How much does an MD seat, MBBS seat, engineering seat, everything we know. So these are the people who are shouting that black money has created a big massive problem. Black money, yes, this demonetization has created a huge problem. GDP will dip. 90% of these people do not know what is GDP. How it is computed. How it will impact. People who do not know all these things are suddenly become. Today India must be the highest economist per capita. Everybody is an economist. Today, Narendra Modi ji, by this demonetization, has given us a new status. The highest number of economists in per capita in anywhere in the world is India. 28th November, the day after tomorrow, there was supposed to be a bung. Opposition parties have withdrawn. Lack of cash. Immediate effect. Oh, people have reacted to the band positively. We have seen Bharat band. Kaan band? Band ki band ho gayi. 1000 rupiah aur 500 rupiah ke rukde nahi hai. Kashmir. Suddenly it is a land of peace. Now it is like heaven. No stone throwing. No stone pelting. No school burning. It is like Belgaum. Very peaceful. You can go there and there is also demonetization talk. There, if Prabhuddha Bharata has a branch, I am ready to go. No problem. Because we may roach 500 rupee, 1000 rupee note imported from Pakistan was creating this stone thing. Let us go. There will be short-term impacts. There will be problems for the farmer. But yesterday we got a news that the Rabi sowing is going on in North India. which is the second crop, especially in Punjab, Haryana, Uttar Pradesh, where they sow for wheat. Compared to last year, same time, the acreage has increased. Farmer doesn't take 1,000 rupee note and sow it. Now our armchair economists in Delhi think 1,000 rupee note is sown and wheat is downloaded from the Google. They do not know how the farmers work. Farmers are not so stupid that they take seeds and do it. They got their own ways and means of gathering seed and they do their own mechanism. They are outside the mechanism of financial world. That is why they do. So farmers are not getting it, but traders are getting it. It is a fact that traders are getting impacted. But you know how it is being sorted out. I asked my mother, and my mother is a great economist. I asked her simply, tomato, potato price, has it gone up after demonetization? Vegetable price, has it gone up? Whether prices of essentials has gone up? That means farm gate to your plate, there is a supply problem because of demonetization. The mother tells me there is no problem. So that means tomato or potato grown in Ooty finds its way to Coimbatore, from Coimbatore to Coimbatore market, from Coimbatore market to my retail shop, from my retail shop to my house. Seamlessly it is happening. And that is a good idea, and I'm sure bear it out to me, that whenever agricultural chain goes on seamlessly, now there may be credit interest instead of cash. That I may say to the lorry driver, please take these tomatoes, I don't have money. But a lorry from Coimbatore or Ooty to Chennai is not going to be in 100 rupees. It is not going to be in 1,000 rupees. It's 9,000 rupees, 10,000 rupees. You have this 2,000 rupee note already coming in, taking care of it, if it is bulk transaction. The problem is between transaction between 100 rupees and 2,000 rupees. It is not mean all transactions interest. You can go even to a shop today and take a cup of tea, no problem. But the problem is if you go and buy the same tea in an airport which will cost you 350 bucks, you do not know what to do. That is where the problem starts, that is where it is hurting. This will have other consequences also. Black money, or what is called as this red money, green money, grey money, whatever color of money except white, fueled ostentatious consumption. So you could go and buy a branded watch for 18 lakhs and show it off. That will stop. You could go and buy one cell phone for 12 lakhs, that will stop. These type of ostentatious consumption, which was vulgar, that will stop. So that is the type of people who proliferate in Latin's Delhi. Demonetization is anti-constitutional. When you bring the constitution, that means it is the last argument of every scoundrel. So you have to go, so immediately rush to the Supreme Court and say, Article 14. What is Article 14? How does it come in? Article 19, where is the role of RBI? Where is the role of Supreme Court? Nothing needs to be examined. All that you have to shout is, I am for the common man. I am going there because my Rolex watch cannot be purchased tomorrow. This is, today you have to see the seething anger of media and enjoy it. You have to see the seething anger of Latians Delhi, bureaucracy. Bureaucracy is stunned that they never expected Mr. Narendra Modi to take a war. See, Professor Vaidyanathan of IIM Bangalore also used to tell us, of course, lightheartedly, that black money is something that it does not enter the government's coffers, but it is still working within the economy. It is still working, but it is not working for the government. You can charge the black money of being an outlaw. Red money goes out of this country. That means it says this country, it has no faith on the country itself. And that is the type of red money that we are talking about. It says that I don't care about India, I don't bother about India, I do not like India. So it goes away. And this is treason. So this is what we are facing today. That people who piled up cash, and you should see the cash that we are talking about. And this is not aimed at businessmen. Demonetization, no businessman will keep cash in the house of 300 crores, 500 crores, unless he is a party MP also. So there are some of them who are MPs and also businessmen. Because businessmen understand that rokda ghar mein rakhne par uska problem hai. He always wants it to be rotating for him, do work for him. But it is the political parties which require money. My state is extraordinarily known. Whenever there is election, this 1,000 rupee note starts circulating along with newspapers in the morning. So every day when the newspaper is distributed, the day prior to election, in the door you will find, you know, new 1,000 rupee crisp notes used to come. Political parties require cash. Bureaucracies, type of corruption that we had, and if I will make it bold, I will even add the word judiciary. And this demonetization hurts them because they only take it in cash. You don't go and bribe an income tax officer and say, I have a land in Bangalore, piece of land, I will give it to you. You only tell him, I will give you a suitcase. And that is how bribes are taken, that is how bribes are given. That's how bribes are extracted. So 15 lakh crores of high denomination note, the first question is, how did we allow in a country of poor 86% notes to be of high value? First question that we need to ask the previous regime, why did you allow country to come to a pass where 86% of the notes were high value denomination notes, not 50 rupee note, not 100 rupee note, but only 500 and 1000? Why did this happen? This happened because there was a calculated design to dilute the clear planned assault on the economy. Let us be very clear about it. Let us not be namby-pamby and say, oh, this man was an economist, so. No, he was not an economist, he was an anti-national. If this was allowed under his nose and he is called an economist, good luck to your intelligence. High value circulation of notes, 17 lakh crores, or out of 17 lakh crores, 15 lakh crores. Now what could happen? I do not know. How much will come back? I do not know. Government is making life miserable for the last 3 lakh crores, 3 to 4 lakh crores to come into the system. Ladies and gentlemen, the success of the scheme will be in one benchmark. If 3 lakh crores don't make it to the government coffers, it will be the success of the scheme. That means RBI can extinguish its liability to the extent of 3 lakh crores. That means RBI can declare a dividend, special dividend of 3 lakh crores to the government. That means government can put 5,000 rupees in every Jandan account that will still cost it 50,000 crores. That means government can capitalize all banks, nationalized banks which are facing problems because of loans given by the previous regime and have dodgy balance sheet now, and they require anywhere between 1.5 lakh to 2 lakh crores in one shot in 1 year. That means government can increase income tax limit from 2.5 lakh rupees to 10 lakh rupees easily. You can see the possibility. I can list endlessly as a chartered accountant, I can go on calculating. But the success of the scheme will lie in your hand to ensure that the corrupt don't put money into their accounts through various other sources. Do not camouflage. And the rise in Jandan account, 63,000 crores suddenly, till day before yesterday, no money. Suddenly there's a Jandan account, people, poor people are putting 63,000 crores. How come? Obviously it is not their money. Till 2 years back, they did not have bank account. It was told, oh, bank account lekar kya karenge? Then bank account aa gaya. 30 crore bank account, Jandan account were opened. Arey, bank account aa gaya, so what? They don't have money. Now 63,000 crores has been pumped into these Jandan accounts. Now there is no questions being asked, no answer being given. See, you understand what is happening. If it is genuine money, people will start banking habits. If it is ingenuine money, government will come out with a scheme. Already they are coming out with a scheme to ensure that they will not be able to withdraw. Damned if you do, doomed if you don't. See, the problem with this Narendra Modi ji is, he has, as I said, the lust for office is not there. And once it is not there, Indians understand. And genetically we have been told that don't worry about the marks in your exam. Read well. Prepare well. Even while playing cricket, we are told, keep your front foot forward, drive it accordingly, you know, keep your head down. You may still get an edge and it may go for a catch behind the keeper. But this is the technique you should employ. We love this because we are one society, we are trained on the process, not on the outcome. Karmanye vadhikarasya maphalesya kadacha. Indians realize that Prime Minister is doing his duty to fight black money. He may succeed, he may not. But he will not be going down as a past Prime Minister and say that organized murder when something good is happening. At least he will have the temerity to tell the next generation, look, I have done something, okay, I have failed or so on. I'm sure he is not going to fail. Assuming that he fails, I'm giving the contra-argument. Here is a Prime Minister who has put his entire political capital on the block. Have you ever seen something like this happen? The nearest I can think about is when Indira Gandhi caught the imagination of the people. I was too young at that time, probably a toddler, between 69 and 71. When she did the bank nationalization, abolition of privy purses, they captured the imagination of the people. Good, bad, ugly, I'm not into it. But she captured the imagination of the people. People were with her. She swept the 71 polls, 72 polls. She went into Bangladesh, she created Bangladesh. People were with her. In 1991, the reforms came. I see this as big as the reforms initiated by Narasimha Rao in 1991. This is as big as the Green Revolution ushered by Lal Bahadur Shastri ji. The effects will not be felt. So you cannot say by December 1 or January 1 whether things will get all right. This is not an effect that will be visible even for the next 5, 7 years, 10 years it may take. And in this cleansing, when the virus attacks your computer, when you load the antivirus, you have to reboot the computer, and when you reboot it, you run the risk of loss of data, you run the risk of several other things, but you know your computer starts performing better. Narendra Modi has rebooted the Indian economy. And in this rebooting, let me be very clear to you all that there will be a cost that all of us has to pay. It will be a secular cost that all of us has to pay across the board. Some of us have to stand in the queue, some of us our business will get affected, some of us will have impact several other places. But you know what, today I feel very happy as a chartered accountant. The respect for my profession goes up million times. Clients who told me, get lost, we know how to manage our black affairs, are queuing in my office and asking, sir, kuch to batao. And I'm refusing to take calls. He has resurrected the brand image of one profession instantly on 8th of November. And I'm eternally thankful to him as a chartered accountant. The second one, this afternoon, when I was with Mr. Bhandari ji's house, I saw a small press release in Beijing. Chinese media say that even their government would not have contemplated of something like this. We always, world over, the idea is India is a soft state. They don't like to eat ganna. They like to eat, drink only ganna juice. So you give them ganna juice, they'll be happy. You know what? It transforms the image of government of India, that here is a set of people in Delhi, the ruling class, which will not hesitate to take tough decisions, and people will back it. If once this message is given, world will behave with us properly. Till date we always were namby-pamby, people will be there, we will not take tough decisions. When tough decisions are taken, people will not be communicated. Here is one instance where people have said, yes, we will take this problem on our chin and we will stand by the leadership of this country. It revolves around the people only and how you communicate. It is very easy to say that, oh, there is a problem, and you know how it is magnified. 70 people have lost their life. Of course, one is sorry for people. Any single loss of life is a tragic thing. But in this country, right from a lift to an education institution, from womb to tomb, we have to stand in a queue. Even in a crematorium, we cannot go and get burnt so easily. We have to stand or at least sleep in a queue. I hope you get what I mean. And who created this shortage? Let us all think about it. That I would put it as a last part of my presentation. Where did we get this shortage? And why is black market there? And black market leads to black money. From education to health to transportation to railway tickets to crematorium to birth certificate to land records, everywhere there is a shortage. Why is there a shortage? Because Pandit Nehru thought that state should be the arbiter of all shortages. Keep eternally this country in poverty, and then state will interlock and decide how to distribute the poverty between people. We only distributed poverty, not wealth. We never distributed anything good to the people. We said, okay, we will distribute only so much grams of rice, so we will have a ration shop. We will have only so much schools. We will have so many doctors only. We will have, of the doctors, we will export 50% of them to America. We will have 4 IITs, out of which 2 will be earmarked for Silicon Valley. You know, we created everything in shortages. Have you ever thought what is the combined effect of the shortages in this country? Nehruvian economics has killed more implicitly than Hitler or Mao or anybody. Let us be very clear about it. It may be that we are wiser by hindsight. It may be that I am talking from experiences. Perhaps I would have talked differently had I been there in 1950s. Probably yes. But Nehruvian economics has created this era of shortages, has made Indians stand in queue for every damn thing. From rice to wheat to lift to education, everything. People stand 2 days in the queue for putting their child in LKG. Medical seat at 2 crores, 5 crores. What type of country have we created in the last 60 years? You know, this is really, really surprising that we are not putting the Nehruvian economics in the context. This is the time to do it. So why are we soaked in such poverty? We are ranked 80 out of 105 countries in hunger index. You will be shocked that 100 countries have eliminated hunger. Hunger remains in another 105 countries. And if you take the list, we are ranked 80th. Do you know which is the 79th country? It is North Korea. Even today, we consume 420 grams of food grains per day per capita, which is lower than the beginning of Green Revolution. And British Famine Commission in 1880 recommended that if India has a famine, we must feed this enslaved population 500 grams per day per capita during famine. Who has created all these things? The list is endless. But ladies and gentlemen, it is time to go back and to our drawing board and ask ourselves this fundamental question. Black money is a product of black economics. Black economics is a product of black politics. This country, we had enough of black economics and black politics for the last 65 years, which assumed that the government will be at the center stage of every damn thing that you and I do. If corruption has to go, government has to be within its limits. There is a role for government, we are not saying. And in fact, you began with Chanakya. Chanakya says only one wonderful thing. He says, it is easy to find out when the fish will drink water, but it is very difficult to find out when the government officer will take money. So it is difficult to eradicate corruption, but you can eradicate the role of government. And unless we march towards liberalism, a liberal set of values, where the government is not seen as arbitrator of all that is to be brought in, and Nehruvian economics has to be buried fathoms deep, we have to remove that mindset that Sarkar aakar hamare liye kuch karegi. Unless we do this, we will face yet another crisis 10 years, 15 years down the line. To tackle red money, black money, grey money, green money, this is just a first step. Don't even call it as a battle. But be prepared for several other more steps that Narendra Modi will take. I only wish that he succeeds for the nation and for the next generation that's going to follow. Because India has to survive if humanity has to survive. It is the responsibility of all of us here that this is a time that we stand with the government, extend it the fullest support, and ensure that Narendra Modi succeeds in this endeavor. If we don't, and God forbid if he fails, and I'm sure he will not, but if he fails, this will be the last battle that we will take on corruption, black money, red money, green money, everything, for the next 30, 40 years. Still we have another, for this generation it is all over. In our times we will not see this happen. So with folded hands, I only make a plea that all of us bear this problem. This is going to be a temporary phenomenon. And there is no assurance that after January 1, it is going to be milk and honey. Let us also be very clear about it. This is like a surgery that has been done with the hope that you will survive. And we have to undergo this surgery not because there was no other option. We had to do it because it has come to a stage that without surgery we didn't have a chance. With surgery we may have a chance. And at every stage I only plead, and I know this is a very, very intellectual audience, don't get carried away by the propaganda of our friends in the opposition. Good people speaking good English is not good economics. That is the Chidambara Rahasyam. 4 learned, erudite, former governors of RBI, Dr. Rangarajan, Y.V. Reddy, Bimal Jalan, and D.V.V. Subbarao, all 4 of them have more or less come to an opinion that this was needed for this country. They are apolitical, they are erudite, they know what they are talking. There are lot of people who across the board, including in IMF and in World Bank, have said this scheme is good, this scheme has to come for this country. We cannot, with our porous borders, have an economy which is dependent on cash. We have to move towards a limited cash economy. Don't think I'm talking about a cashless economy. I'm talking about a limited cash economy. Paytms and credit cards and debit cards will be the order of the day. This is what we may also have to do as an individual. And unless we start doing these things from our side also, it is not going to be a smooth sailing. But last but not the least, never ever hesitate to ask the question to all those who question this scheme. What have they done when their turn was there for the last 10 years? That is the crucial thing. If they don't have an answer, they don't deserve to fight, you know, ask a question now. With that, I stop. Thank you.
Sir, for introducing us to all the different colors of money. Incidentally, I don't know how many of the audience know, sir is the author of a book called Shri Manmohan Singh, A Decade of BK, and he has almost clarified that for us today. Although having heard him for the past 45 minutes, I'm sure the subject is crystal clear, but it might have ignited some questions in the minds of our audience. We now throw the floor open for questions. I request the volunteers of Prabuddha Bharat to please manage the mics.
Hello. Many economists, prominent economists have criticized this scheme. Now you have touched upon this to some extent, but it's a... They have criticized this scheme on the So, what is the correct answer?
Sir, this is not an answer that they will find it in their textbooks. And this is, if I may put it very bluntly, sponsored criticism. They have to criticize because they do not know what to say. And if you find there are equal number of economists who are also welcome, the criticism of the scheme is that the common man is undergoing hardship. Nothing more. And the answer to that has been given by the common man by silently standing and bearing the problem. When the common man, when the economists don't represent the common man, how do they claim to bat for the common man? And the common man is disengaged from those economists. And when were they, when the common man was standing in the queues, as I said, from womb to tomb? When were they? They prescribed this economics that has brought us to this stage that we are ranked 80 out of 105 countries in the hunger index. So let us throw away these people, sir. Let us look at it very positively. My only plea that let us not get carried away just because economists, the word missed is there in economist. So be clear. They are not clear about things.
As an economist, when he was...
Was he?
He was not. That's what I'm trying to say.
Okay.
He was not trained in economics. And the only reason he sustained for all these decades was Prasanna Chandra Mahalanobis, PC Mahalanobis, assisted him by ripping off the entire Russian model. So I think it's high time we discredit him of all the credit that he has been...
This is the time.
This is really high time. And
this is the time. Black money has to be spoken along with black economics,
along with black politics. If you speak only about black money, this is going to be a very, very small, trivial affair. This is not. What Modi has done is to churn. And in this churn, the first... wish that is coming out is Modinomics, you know, which is placing Nehru-nomics as in the rightful place it should be.
More on our integral demography.
Agreed. See, what happens in all these things, it is
very, very easy to speak amongst ourselves and say we should have an economic thought that is rooted in our cultural. But if you start doing this, you are not an economist. The Delhi fellows will say, "Arey, ye to pagal hai. Kavita likhne aaya hai. Economics is from West." Please understand, modern medicine cannot be from India. Modern economics also cannot be from India. Modern law cannot be from India. Constitution cannot be from India. We are surviving on all external gadgets. So you are right, we require. But the moment we start doing this, the Delhi gang and the elite gang will say that you are pagal hai, to kavita likhne aaya. So we have to be very careful. The moment you get discredited, you will not talk also. That is why the problem with these people not accepting Narendra Modi is that he is rooted to the ground and he is fighting it in the traditional manner. For diabetes, he is not giving you 10 mg, 5 mg of this medicine. He is saying do yoga. That is the problem. So you are right. But the mindset has to percolate along.
First of all, I would like to thank you for coming all the way from Chennai to
Pleasure.
On behalf of all Kalyan people, I extend my gratefulness for that. Now, having talked about decoding demonetization, what will be the effects on the properties, assets, in terms of gold, jewelry, diamond, or real estate that has been already capitalized? Okay, prior to it, because the moment Modi announces at 8 p.m., the gold shops were open till the morning, you know, trying to encash that into gold. So a substantial amount of gold would have already come in. Already there is a rumor of the marketplace is having, you know, parallel economy that's going on in the case of 70-30, 60-40, in case of Mumbai it is 50-50, you know, you give a black 50 and take white. So there are certain effects that are there. And what is the way ahead in terms of, you know, capitalization of the black money, which has become
first thing, a scheme of this size and the country of this complexity will always have some leakages. We want
100% success, or we say we don't want the scheme. That can never happen. Even when a farmer does a harvest of, say, mangoes or apples or paddy or whatever, whatever is in the farm is not going to get into the market 100%. There will be leakages. In these type of schemes, there will be people who will convert, there will be people who will do things. How many of you know that raids are happening even as we speak on various gold merchants? Gold merchants happen till that 12 midnight. Afterwards, not much of gold sales is happening. Hawala transactors who are using local currency and giving dollars, and they thought they can do the business and they can also do some exchange, they also stopped. Raids are happening. ED and income tax are raiding people. Simultaneously, some bank officers also reported to have helped people in, you know, doing these transactions. That is also happening. But you cannot blame Narendra Modi for that. This will happen in a country like this only. Answer your, what was your second question on the gold getting capitalized, I got it. All assets. Yes. See, that is why I made a passing remark that all these gold, illegal property, all these things are byproduct of corruption. And the first step of corruption is notes. It is not in gold or in diamond or in jewelry or in property. First step is transaction in cash. That is being addressed. That has been put an end to. That has been completely stopped. Now, whether tomorrow a fresh 2000 rupee note will be offered as bribes? Yes, it will be. There will definitely people will now ask you, not don't give me 1000 rupees, give me 2000 rupees. Now I used four colors, they are now asking the fifth color, pink money. Okay, that will come. But in a house where we live, there is always some muck that accumulates. We have to daily clean it. That is why we always believe that this war for good and bad is always eternal. In one shot, good does it. After Duryodhana's death, it is not that bad has ceased to exist. After Kamsa's death, bad has ceased to exist. No. After Kamsa, there was Duryodhana. Before that, there was Ravana. After that, there are somebody else. So this will go on. We have to go on fighting. And in this war, are you with Krishna or are you with Duryodhana? That is the question. And I leave it to you and your conscience.
After the demonetization of 500 and 1000 notes, you were saying that, you know, 86% of our economy is running because of these.
I never said that. I said 86% of the currencies were high value currencies.
86% of the currencies were
high value currencies.
So what was the reason that the government decided to launch the 2000 rupee note? I mean, I read somewhere that, you know, Mr. Bokil, who some time ago, you know, gave his ideas. He said that, you know, it should be anything less than 100.
That's right.
What was the reason of this 2000?
Another 8 p.m. will Prime Minister will come. And probably he may withdraw 2000 rupee note.
Don't rush. But why he gives this 2000 rupee note is, when you withdraw 15 lakh crores from the system, you have to pump in at least 10 lakh crores quickly. If you do it in 100 rupee note, it will take 10 times more time to print. If you do it 2000 rupee, you are actually reducing the time by half. And in case of 500 rupee note, you are actually reducing by 4 times. Okay. Now what he has done, he has brought in a new notes, which one chartered accountant from Surat has explained why he has done it also. That also has been brilliantly explained by chartered accountant. So to under Mr. Bokil, destination point is correct. The road to heaven may be through him. That's why I said we should wait till the last reel. We should not wait for heaven in the first reel. If then maja nahi aayega na. So wait. I'm sure this has been done with a plan. They have to put money into the hands of the people. 500 rupee notes are also coming in. Probably I'm told even 1000 rupee notes will come back. But once they come back, they will also be withdrawn. So, you know, in some phrases, they will also try to put it back. So, wait. This is only a trailer. Main picture baki hai. What is it? Yes.
Why not start the religious institutes?
Of?
All the religious institutes, like Tirupati, then Shirdi Sri Vaibha. All these places. Now we will definitely get this 1,500 rupee note. Why can't this illegal tender can be straight away set aside instead of allowing them to exchange it with the RBI?
Yes, it is a
very good suggestion. I think they should have done it at the first stage itself. Are they exchanging in bulk? That data is not out. My guess is every day, TTD at least I know, banks its previous day hundi collection into the bank. At best, TTD could have had 8th collection, which it could have used the TTD trustees probably, I am not accusing, since you are saying that, I am saying probably they could have used it for some purpose. Religious institutions. But also please understand, many of them do this banking very promptly. Some of them don't do, some of them will be exchanging, of which some of them will be exchanging with even terrorists. I agree with you. We can't set aside so.
He is not so sacrosanct.
I agree. See, already he is termed
as Hitler. Already he is termed as Tuklak. Every day they are changing the name, no? Last week it was Hitler, now it is Tuklak. Next week what it will be, I do not know. Exactly. Jitna chilla rahe hain, itna scheme successful hai. The more Mamta is shrill, I only use Mamta as a yardstick. The more she shouts, I know that it is hurting her. The more Mulayam is shouting, I know it is hurting. The more Karunanidhi is shouting, I know it is successful. So don't worry about, there will be leakages. Don't get into this, you know, doctor type of, you know, that surgeon, that it has to be so precise, laser-like, that it cannot be happening. So there will be so many problems. Government would have thought about banning this also. Good idea. Probably it can be carried out. I will try to pass it on and you can also do it in mygov.in. It's a good idea. But there will be practical difficulties. And by this time, they are not going to exchange it in the banks also. They have to only deposit it. How?
Find a viability to exchange anywhere else. So they have given into the hands of God.
Once it is into this trust, you should know how the
trust account works. It cannot again go and give back them loans. Or it cannot give it back to them. Bank mein aajayega, theek hai. So what? So it has gone into the trust. Sir, Tirupati trust se main kaise nikalunga? That case, trust ko mil gaya. Trust, we will take it care of it. We will pass one ordinance and take care.
What he says, sir, that 3 lakh crore is there, na, it may involve some fake currency also. That's what.
No, fake currency is being segregated.
They are putting the hundis, no, sir. That's what he has got doubt. So, how can you make distinction at that time? 3 lakh crores are white money.
No. He's asking if 3 lakh crores are. It is not fake account. He's only asking if those who are having black money, instead of giving it to the government or keeping it in the mattress, go and put it in the hundi, what will happen? We'll pass an ordinance and take over. After 8th November, whatever is being deposited to the banks by
religious institution, bhaiyo aur behno, usko maine le liya. See, this good thing about this man is he's not getting confused. He may be wrong. As one great lawyer in Britain said, clients come and pay me money not to listen to my confusion. I may be wrong, sometimes I am, but people don't come up, pay me money to listen to my confusion. Okay, this man is not confused. So you will straight away come at 8 p.m.
A country like ours, which has been obsessed with money, cash, since the last 70 years, how it will be for a country to get cash limited economy or plastic economy? And second quick question is, with all 500,000 rupees notes out of the currency, how are all the political parties going to contest the mini Lok Sabha elections, that is UP elections, next year?
First one is, don't underestimate the
genius of our people to go to cashless. Vegetable vendors and auto drivers are now using Paytms and wallets, e-wallets and other things. So don't think that these are so technically complex that only a chartered accountant or an IIT graduate only will use it. Everybody will start using it. Second, as far as your mini elections is concerned, and UP, especially UP, Punjab, I am sure it will affect all the parties, and it is affecting. Even today I saw Ben Mayawati shouting, and they will continue to shout. Because what they have lost is not only political capital, they also lost financial capital. This is a surgical strike that has pauperized them financially and pauperized them ideologically. So this will definitely impact, but whether it will have any benefit for BJP or something, I am not going to pass judgment now. It will take time, because probably when the elections are held, it will be held at the peak of what is called as the peak of your frustration curve also. At that time, the people will actually be frustrated in terms of cashless. Probably the effects may flow after 6 months, but at that time they will find it difficult. At this point in time, yes, the people seem to be reacting very favorably. At least I would say there is a overarching, I am not going into opinion polls of either Narendra Modi or Times of India or anything else. I am only saying that by and large people are orderly behavior in the banks and in ATMs demonstrate that by and large things are working.
Currency printing company, there are three such through which RBI operates. The company by name DLRU. So this was involved in some of pumping extra currency into the market. This article I just came across. Like, how much is it true? And
till I came to the hall, it is only RBI that can introduce the currency.
Given this contract to three companies.
That they can do. They can do it from Nashik. They have also given it to some other people outside the country also. Dr. Subramanian Swamy has raised this issue very heavily, that how can you give it to an outside, and this is also, this 2000 rupee notes are
per state. Not only make in India, it is made in Mysore. So you should all be very happy about it. The 2000 rupee note comes from Mysore only. So having given the contract outside, this was all done at that time, probably for some reason, we do not know for what. Hopefully it will stop. With this, it will stop. Probably in the Mysore press will and Nashik press will be doing this better. Don't let us not blame the contractor for it. It was basically the political leadership that failed us by pumping this amount of cash.
Yes, sir. As per my knowledge, after independence, this black money started happening. Once this scheme is declared, people are saying that the entire black money will go off. But as you said, nobody has kept that money in house or somewhere. They already converted that money into some assets, or maybe sent money abroad then brought back to stock exchanges. And all those beneficiaries are enjoying their properties and money and earning dividends also. So can we say that this is a immunity scheme from all those people who have did all these things? And what will happen on 1st January? Because once this money is drawn from people and deposited in bank, how this economy will again start working properly since 1st January?
Sir, first thing is black money has several avatars.
Cash is first avatar, Matsya avatar. Then Kurma, Varaha, Vamana, Narasimha, it goes on. Gold, property, jewelry, various other things, medical seat, all these things are various avatars are there. Now, what he has done is he has tackled first avatar. First day itself, we want him to tackle all the Nava. Even Vishnu took time for Nava, nine avatars. That is why I am saying, let us wait. First Matsya avatar has come, so Vishnu is alive. So let us wait and give some time to see what is happening. If news circulating in the public domain is anything correct, he is now going to ask digitization of property records, especially for bureaucracy is very scared about this. Judiciary is scared about this, because most of the property that is being purchased is kept in Benami names. The Benami Act has been passed. Now they are going to ask, okay, Mr. X, you are owner of this property in Lalbagh area, multi-story building, show me where is your income tax record for the last 6 years. Sir, I'm filing 1 lakh rupee return. Finished. That he will say, who you please surrender this property, this will be taken away. As far as property, just a second. For black money kept abroad, take it from me, there is going to be an ordinance that is going to come in and we are going to nationalize all accounts abroad. And if you show proper proof that you have taken it away from India or you are a non-resident Indian or you have earned it abroad India and you are entitled under FEMA to keep that money outside India, you will be allowed to take it. Otherwise, Sarvam Krishnarpanam. See, he is prepared. He is starting slowly. First trial dose diya hai. When cancer patient are there, sorry if somebody is there, they will know it also. Chemotherapy is never administered in large dose. First is test dose. This is a test dose. Main dose will come. So just wait. We are all knowing about what we are talking. We are understanding what is happening. It is difficult in a country like this where there is no digital records. And unless you capture the big data, and unless you run a proper query, you will not come get into any answers. He is first capturing the big data.
The RBI not govern and regulate any entity that is engaged in banking, like cooperative societies, which is used as a tool for parking illicit funds. I think that societies also get governed and regulated by RBI. Somewhere there will be a check on the mechanism to hold future subsequent generation of this black money.
See, my view is that RBI has been regulating finance companies. And after it has died, and it has gone belly up, RBI will come and place the wreath. Tell me one instance where RBI has been proactive in taking steps in preventing a fraud in a finance company. RBI genetically is not suited for, it is not a fraud detective agency. It is a monetary, see, suddenly take a monetary agent and suddenly ask him to become CBI. RBI cannot become CBI. Neither can CBI become RBI. See, frauds will happen wherever there is finance, only way to fight frauds is to penalize people heavily for either committing fraud or abetting fraud. That is why I have always held that the past Prime Minister must be held accountable for his deeds of being an abettor to all the crimes that happened to him. Take action on him. Then you will see everything will settle. If you don't take action on him, then automatically where you will take action? See, it is a golden opportunity that we set a very, very stringent example of taking action on a man who allowed a loot of 10 lakh crores from this country, watched it silently, then comes and talks about loot and plunder now. That is why I am saying, all you are talking about is chiller and naya paisas, whereas we are talking in a larger context.
But you did not mention Raghuram Rajan. Yes. Was that one of the reasons why you think he was not continued for this term?
No, I do not know Mr. Raghuram Rajan's views on this matter, though this morning I got something which I am not very sure it can be attributed to him.
I consciously and deliberately avoided mentioning his name. Not that for any bias. These four people have been specifically mentioned in a news article, so I mentioned. Unless Mr. Raghuram Rajan makes his view known, we cannot assume that for or against it, but I don't also want to comment whether he was removed because of this scheme or because of that scheme. Government is entitled to carry its program. Raghuram Rajan's term had come to an end, and they found it fit that they wanted to replace with somebody else, and that somebody else was a deputy governor. Somebody was caught from some local market. He was also a person of some stature, and again, to say that, you know, that man doesn't know, this man doesn't know, again, is a very wrong thing. He is also a man of great stature. Probably only one thing, that government and Raghuram Rajan were going together also on certain things, because this preparation should have happened somewhere in the month of March. This did not happen only in September 15th and November 8th. This was done. This was not done that way. This was done, enormous preparation was carried out. So probably Raghuram Rajan was also party to it. So, unless we hear it from him authentically, I didn't want to comment.
Sir, you mentioned him, and also we heard a lot from Sri Subramanian Swami regarding participatory notes and the involvement of Mr. Chidambaram's son in certain transactions. What will happen to this black money which is outside?
See, my book, Sense, Sensex, Sentiments, Failure of India's Financial Sentinels,
is dedicated to participatory notes. I have written a book only on participatory notes, black money, and how it is being used for laundering and how it is a big vehicle. My grouse with this government is that it has not yet banned participatory notes. But I am also confident that this term of this government is ending only by May 2019. So we are still interval. If I have to use the metaphor of a film, interval abhi aaya. So let me get the popcorn and watch. Now it's getting... Exactly.
One thing, he has claimed this to be a monumental mismanagement. In your opinion, could it have been done in any other way?
That is for Mr. Manmohan Singh to say. Now this man allowed 10 crore loot.
He is the prime accused in coal. And he talks about morality. By definition, this is Kali Yuga. Thank you.
I request the convener of Sri Chaitanya Kulkarni to now propose the vote of thanks.
Namaskar, dignitaries on and off the dais. Indeed, it's a great opportunity to stand before this intellectual gathering to propose vote of thanks for a program which is the need of the nation today. First and foremost, I would like to thank the Honorable Prime Minister, Sri Narendra Modi ji, for the bold steps taken to eradicate the terrorism and to curb the parallel economy in a single step. On behalf of Prabuddha Bharata, I congratulate and thank Honorable Prime Minister for his courageous steps. Sir, we are thankful to the noted economist and the chartered accountant, Sri M.R. Venkatesh, for decoding the demonetization. Sir, you have enlightened us the causes, effects, and the way ahead of demonetization. Thank you, sir, for accepting our invitation and making this interaction fruitful. Prabuddha Bharata is ever thankful to the Karnataka Law Society and Sri Raj Belgaonkar. We started the journey of Prabuddha Bharata from this beautiful auditorium. Folks, most of our programs are held in this auditorium. This shows the concern of this humble gentleman who always said yes to any help. Today, it was an opportunity to hear Raj Belgaonkar. Sir, we are thankful for sharing your views and gracing this function as the chief guest. The gracious presence of you all has made this event a grand success. On behalf of Prabuddha Bharata, I thank from the bottom of my heart for the support extended by the audience at large for all our events. My special thanks to media who has spread the awareness of this program to the public, and also I'm sure that they will cover this great program in a good pattern. I appreciate and thank the members of the press, print, social, and electronic media for their presence. I would like to thank the staff and the management of IMER for providing this beautiful auditorium and also assisting us on this occasion. Last but not the least, I thank Asawari Sant for being the great MOC. Thank you, one and all. Jai Hind.
Decided by Kumari Prajakta Gokhale.
Shitala Sasya Shamala Mataram Vande Mataram Shubhra Josna Pulakita Yamini Shobhini Suhasini Sumadhura Bhashini Sukhadam Varadam Mataram Vande Mataram Vande Kantha Kalakala Ninada Karale Koti Koti Bhujai Druta Khara Karavale Abala Keno Mai Tupale Bahubala Dharini Namami Tarini Ripudalavarini Mataram Vande Mataram Tumhi Vidya Tumhi Dharma Tumhi Rudi Tumhi Marma Tvamhi Prana Sharire Bahute Tumi Ma Shakti Hridaye Tumi Ma Bhakti Tomarai Pratima Gadi Mandire Mandire Tvam hi Durga Dashaprahran Dharini Kamala Kamaladala Viharini Vani Vidya Daini Namami Tvam Mataram Namami Kamala Amalam Atulam Sujalam Sufalam Mataram Vande Mataram Shamalam Saralam Susmitam Bhushitam Dharanim Bharanim Mataram Vande Mataram Vande Mataram Bolo Bharat Mata Ki.